smelled like a complete and total campfire, and you could see the mountains directly around us, and, well, there's mountains directly around us, and I took some pictures, and if I can ever figure out how to put voiceover pictures, then I'll put together a picture collage and show you guys what it really looked like. But, gosh, I wish that it would dump rain or snow or something and just put all these fires out. Anyways, just wanted to come on here and show you that. I don't know, my mind is going so many different directions right now with the new mandates that came out yesterday and just trying to figure out what to do in certain situations. And my kids' school has now decided that they're going to be authoritarians and make them wear masks again. And they're not supposed to. Our governor signed an emergency order through the health department that the health department for the state of Montana put out, saying that parents needed to be given the choice to opt their kids out of wearing masks at school. And because the wording says should, they are able to say, okay, well, here's your opt-out choice. You can go fully online. And that's the only opt-out choice we've been given. Because we're supposed to be able to opt them out for religious, for health, for we just don't want them to wear it reasons, pretty much anything. And their opt-out choice is go fully online. Well, my kid's taking a pottery class. You can't exactly do that online. He's taking choir. You can't exactly do that online. You know, how do you do band online? How do you do choir? How do you do pottery? How do you do art? None of that stuff is a viable option for an online class. And I know a lot of you are going to say, just homeschool them, just homeschool them. Yeah, I know, I could. But I'm also running a business, and I'm out all day long. So they'd have to do what they could figure out during the day on their own, and then we'd have to stay up half the night for me to teach them at night. You know, there's some people in the area that have talked about coming up with a homeschool co-op that would help parents that are working or parents that are just not qualified to teach their children. Because that's the other thing is, I am awful at math. I looked at a chart yesterday that somebody posted in a canning group, and it was like, here, does this help? And it was some kind of comparative measurement thing, and I'm like, what? And everybody's like, oh my gosh, this is great. This is wonderful. Oh, I need this. Oh, I'm going to go get a poster board. Oh, I'm going to print this off. And I'm sitting there going, am I the only one who doesn't have any clue what this means? And everybody's like, oh, fractions at its best. And I'm like, makes me want to cry just thinking about it. Irregardless, I'm not qualified to teach my children at home. I've tried it and they did okay, but that was in younger grades. it was passed a few months back. They cannot do that here. But with the authoritarian regime that is in D.C. trying to force it anyways, I'm waiting to see what's going to happen. I have an email into the governor's office, and I am waiting to hear back. If I don't hear from him by today, he's going to get more emails over the weekend. I want to know what he's going to do. And I want to know what I can do to help. If there's letters that can be written, phone calls to be made, I don't care. I'm over this, and I'm not putting up with it anymore. I will not get it, and my family will not get it, and they can't make me. So, I hope you all have a great day. I hope that you stand firm. There, now you can really see the smoke.